So, as some reports indicate, the holiday tech gifts are, I guess, about $90 billion
US. Yeah, that's about
right.
Yeah.
That's the market. So you've brought a sample of some of this stuff that's going to be making it mm-hmm. part of that list. Mm-hmm. What do we have?
Sure. Well, where do we start? I mean, there's just so much variety. Why don't we start with smart speakers, a very popular category in Canada.
Still?
Yeah, absolutely. So there's the two main players. There's the Google Nest or Google Home variety, and then there's the Amazon Alexa powered ones. There's also the HomePod from Apple, but it isn't as intelligent as these other ones that have a built-in assistant that can do so much. So as low as $30 or $40 for this Nest Mini, or a little bit more for louder sound and a more sensitive microphone, these are basically your hands-free personal assistant.
So turn on Christmas.
Yeah, you could say turn on the lights on this beautiful festive set. So smart home control is one application. Playing your music, you can say, play me Christmas music. Stream your favorite radio stations, play podcasts and audiobooks, get weather information, flight details. I mean, the list goes on and on. It's essentially a voice-enabled computer that won't break the bank. And then
streaming,
smart, yeah. Before we get to Roku, just on that same thought of smart speakers, smart displays are also becoming mm-hmm. trendy in Canada. This is called Portal by Facebook. And yes, you can make Facebook calls over Messenger or WhatsApp. They also own WhatsApp. Free video calls. But it also has built-in Alexa, personal assistant. So again, you could say, show me recipes for chocolate chip cookies, or how many calories are in a chocolate chip cookie if you want to ask.
I never ask that question.
You don't want to. But it's a smart display, which is also very popular. It's $179 for that. Now, yeah, you were pointing at the Roku. So this, speaking of streaming, this is a device that turns your regular TV into a smart TV. So for as low as $39, you snap this into the HDMI port of any television, join your Wi-Fi, and then you've got access to all your favorite streaming services like Netflix or Amazon or Disney Plus and so on. This one is high definition, which is the $39 one, and goes up to $69 for 4K quality if your TV supports that, and a voice remote, so you can actually say what you want to watch and it'll show you across all your services.
The best of Mark Saltzman.
Yeah, right. If there is such a thing. But thank you. Yeah, so audio, very popular. Everybody knows about the AirPods from Apple, those white ones with the longer stick, but these ones are fantastic from Sony. They're simply called wireless in-ear, or truly wireless in-ear headphones, and they are really comfortable, fantastic noise cancellation. In fact, they've got active noise cancellation, which means it introduces an electronic signal to cancel out ambient noise around you, so nothing is between you and your music or your phone calls. Very comfortable, very small, 4.5 hours of battery life, or with this charging case, you get 24 hours. So this protects your earbuds, but they also charge them up at the same time.
And the cost?
So those are $299, so they are a premium product, but not unlike an AirPod. Mm-hmm. Samsung. So this is a smartwatch called the Active 2. It's the Galaxy Watch Active 2, brand new to the market, and it has 39 different activities or functions on the watch itself, ranging from calculating your fitness, of course, your steps taken and your heart rate and even your sleep cycles, to making payments at retail. You can tap this on one of those contactless terminals to buy something, and it's linked to Samsung Pay or Google Pay. You can play your music wirelessly, shows you who's calling, who's texting, and the list goes on and on. As I mentioned, like 39 different activities. You just have that on your wrist, and this is $239 from Samsung, so a great little gift. And that works both with iPhone and Android devices, by the mm-hmm. way, so you don't have to have a Samsung phone.
First of its kind, you were telling me earlier, here in Canada, right?
Right, correct. So it's from Ooma, that's OOMA. So this is, in the box, you've got several door and window sensors that you place around your home. There's a water sensor and a motion sensor. And what this does is, whenever a sensor is triggered, it notifies you on your smartphone anywhere in the world. So it'll say your front door has been opened, or your back window was just opened. And that way you can act on it if you deem it to be a concern. I love the water sensor because, as you know, it's like the number one insurance claim for homes in Canada. So you put that in by a sub pump or by a hot water heater, and if ever detects a leak, you're notified immediately. So to minimize any damage, you can act on it.
Is this enough to eliminate your current home alarm system?
Some people do cancel their monthly alarm service, mm-hmm. but just know that it's not going to call 911 or a private security guard for you. You have to do it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's up to you. Some people augment their home alarm system with something like this,
right.
So they can have an app in that. What I really like about it is that if you have aging parents who live alone, mm-hmm. you can install something like this, and it's only $179, by the way. And if a sensor is not triggered, you could be notified. So if it's unusual that your parents haven't left their bedroom, your right. mom hasn't left her room, and it's 9:30, you could be notified. Or if they haven't opened the fridge or the medicine cabinet in a certain amount of time, you could be notified. You know, so I think that's a nice stay-at-home or aging-in-place, as it's called, technology. Computers. So this is from Dell. It's called the XPS 15. It is has the longest-lasting battery out of any 15-inch laptop in the world at 20 and a half hours, which is fantastic. That's probably four or five times longer than what most laptops can do, without sacrificing performance either. This is a full-performance laptop, so a very, very powerful processor under the hood. So if you do things like video editing or playing games, this would be for you, and that's $1,299. And then finally, we've got some gaming. You know, it is at the end of the year, whether you're a kid or kid at heart, you may want to unwind a little bit over the holidays. Nintendo has had a huge success on their hand with the Nintendo Switch family of devices. They recently introduced the Nintendo Switch Lite. As the name suggests, this is a lighter and more compact gaming system. It's an all-in-one or dedicated console, so that means the controllers don't remove in this one. Mm-hmm. It's actually built in. And it's fun to play at home or on the go. And that
you can take it with you to all your meetings.
I don't know how your boss will feel about that, but yeah, if you're bored, yeah, why not? And that's available for, I believe it's $299. And then finally, for the regular Nintendo Switch, where you can remove the Joy-Cons on the side, this is called the Ring Fit Adventure. It is a great sort of gaming slash exercise companion that lets you strap on that Joy-Con, I'll show you, underneath. You have one on your leg strap, and then mm-hmm. the other one joins this ring, and then those wireless sensors sort of communicate with one another through the activities in this collection of,
right,
of games. And it's great because it's giving you some extra motivation to be fit, right? And really fun for the family, making kind of like what Nintendo did with the Wii. Remember a few years ago, they're kind of bringing that back, if you will. So very clever for that accessory, and that's for the regular Nintendo Switch.
Let me ask you. I mean, you've been doing tech gift guides of mm-hmm. all sorts for
25
so
years, actually. Yeah, it's all right.
What are the predominant gifts? I mean, is it laptops? Is it smartwatches?
It's not a one-size-fits-all scenario. You have to not only assess your budget, but consider who you're shopping for. Not everyone is going to want a smart speaker or have a need for a home security solution. I would always start with, again, who you're buying for. Maybe if they're into reading, they love reading, but they haven't yet bought an e-book reader or a tablet, that might be a logical, mm-hmm. you know, gift for them.
We are doing this just ahead of the holidays, but mm-hmm. I'm wondering whether or not these prices come down after the holidays.
So often it's up to the retailer to drop. They want to get rid of their inventory, you know, after Boxing Day, if that's still a thing. I think Black Friday has really sort of trumped Boxing Day, but certainly come January, February, when new models are introduced, we will often see prices, but I think right now they really want to clear it out. So you're going to get some aggressive pricing now. And online, leverage those apps that will compare prices for you. Use those apps that give you some cash back at places you're already going to shop at mm-hmm. anyways. There's a few really good ones out there that will put some money back in your pocket. And then, we will start seeing prices drop a little bit.
Last question.
Yeah.
What's on your holiday wishes?
A little downtime, I'll be honest with you. I travel a lot. I do love tech, but believe it or not, I love to unwind and decompress and unplug as well. So I'm looking forward to some family time. We'll break out some board games, believe it or not, and some card games. I like taking a bit of a reprieve, a little digital detox, if you will, and then right back into it for next year.